life. It's about dreams, hard work, and opportunity. Sometimes that opportunity is there. And sometimes, well, you have to wait for it. What you're about to see is a story of 75 young ladies who all got together and were given that opportunity to become the best they could be. Not everyone made it until the end, but those who did will have a lifetime of memories that we will always treasure.
Thank you. Bye. to redefine me. Let the word out, I've got to get out. Oh, I'm feeling better now. Break the news out, I've got to get out. Oh, I'm feeling better now. Ooh. Oh, I'm happy as Christmas. Time to celebrate me. Let the word out, I got to get out. Oh, I'm feeling better now. Break the news out, I got to get out. Oh, I'm feeling better. World's done shaking, the world's done shaking, the world's done shaking me down. The world's done shaking, the world's done shaking, the world's done shaking me down.
Why not?
Don't you wanna be?
touchdown. Being a Playwet means years of friendship, the 75 amazing girls, and memories to last a lifetime. What is like to be a Playwet?
Okay, number one. Your parents give up your college funds so that you can wear pretty costumes and, it's a lot of money. And then, number two, Jenny, take it away.
Oh, number two, you basically become pretty annoying around all of your friends because if you get more than two drill team girls together, all you talk about is costume and dances and drill team.
Number three, you can never get the glitter off your body. You find it everywhere.
Being a Playwet means you spend more time up at school than you do in your own house.
I sacrificed my social life a long time ago from being a Playwet.
So, our rehearsal week, I walked home and apparently the lights turn off at 11. Yeah, I had to bump into my car to find it.
And Playwets is basically spending all of your money on costumes that you wear once and then you have to give them back.
Okay, that's about it.
Being a Playwet really sucked.
No, Rachel, you liked it, remember?
Oh, yeah! Hey, what does that stand for?
Well, it stands for three things every Playwet has to have. First, most importantly, you have to have fun. Then there's the new boyfriend thing. And then you've got to have your phones for text messaging.
Wait, phones doesn't start with an F.
Oh, what, you would really know?
Shut up, Brittany. Well, seriously, Playwet's been meeting friends, great memories, dance, tripping and falling, and laughing at each other. And I really enjoyed it.
Great. Oh, yeah, that was really great.
Playwets has been meeting new people, making new friends, learning from the girls around me, building friendships, making wonderful memories, spring show, everything. It's changing my life. It's like,
by the way, I still have those palms and I don't plan on giving them back.
Thank you. Cause Singing bird in an open cage. Who will own?
But most of all, we found ourselves and our friends along the way.
Crying. bad this year, with all the obstacles we had to overcome. Ticket sales were down. Numbers had to be tweaked. Then, I saw the list of dads performing in the father-daughter dance. On that list were names like Mike Hopte, R.J. Harden, Dean Pitter-Patter Purcell, and old Dave Sox Chupac. It was those guys, back in the day, that we looked up to. No one could leap or tap like those guys. They were America's finest dancers and are the reason I took up skating and dancing. We immediately sent out flyers on these guys, back when they were in their prime. After that, ticket sales skyrocketed. We sold out the show.
I saw a Plano performance was right here in 1978 when I attended this school. Sure, I like hunting, fishing, golf, fast cars, but who doesn't? But my real passion is dance. Prior to attending Texas Tech University, I tried a career at dance, but unfortunately a knee injury ended my dreams, my passion, my true desire. The opportunity to dance with this year with Michelle was a blessing. It allowed me to be who I really wanted to be, to get back to my true feelings. I think it showed when we were up on stage compared to the rest of the guys.
Well, when I dance, I tell a story. Not like those other guys, you know, except for Hopte. Now, that's the guy who can dance. He really tells a story. Anyway, me, you know, I kind of have to get into it, you know. I have to feel it, kind of let myself go, you know, do the snaps. That's what I'm talking about.
When I was 7 years old, my dad talked me into taking ballet lessons because he said it would help me in wrestling, football. And when I walked in that studio and I saw those guys wearing those black leotards, I said, no way, that's not for me. Well, after seeing the Planoettes for the first time, I decided to make a career change. When I saw what they were wearing, those black form-fitting spandex pants, I mean, at my age, there's places that you don't want form-fitting black spandex pants.
We didn't have shoes like they have today. I remember my state dance competition back in high school. When I did one of my kick routines, my shoe came off and struck the judge in the head. Well, of course, I was disqualified. I never forgot it, you know, with all the therapy and all. It's a hard fall, being on top 1 minute, then at the bottom the next. It felt good to be back on stage. Spotlights, curtain calls, wall-to-wall guys, I loved it.
a child, before life removed all the innocence, my father would lift me high and dance with my mother and me, and then spin me around till I fell asleep. Then up the stairs he would carry me, and I knew for sure I was loved. If I could get another chance, another walk, another dance with him, I'd play a song that would never, ever end. How I'd love, love, love to dance with my father again. Ooh. When I and my mother would disagree, to get my way I would run from her to him. He'd make me laugh just to comfort me, yeah, yeah. Then finally make me do just what my mama said. Later that night when I was asleep, he left a dollar under my sheet. Never dreamed that he would be gone from me. If I could steal one final glance, one final step, one final dance with him, I'd play a song that would never, ever end. 'Cause I'd love, love, love to dance with my father again. Sometimes I'd listen outside her door, and I'd hear how